Hello, beautiful people, and welcome back to a new video. Thank you for joining me on Patreon, and thank you for joining me on YouTube as well. So today's topic is a very important one, in my opinion, and this is something that not many people in the spiritual community are talking about, because it is kind of controversial, and there's so much misconception around the concept of lower vibrational entities, what they are, and just the concept of hell itself or lower astral levels. And I have been confused around it as well for a long time, and I kind of refuse to look into it because it is not an easy topic and it's not an easy concept to digest for us, but it's very important to do so. So the concept of this lower vibrational plane that is existing parallel to the earth has been present in world religions, in mythology as well. So humanity has been somewhat familiar with the concept of it. However, it's been called hell. And I thought it's very important to clear up this misconception. And what is it? What is this lower aspect of the earth plane that is existing in parallel to it? In one of my videos, I was talking about the Venusian collective, when I channeled them and where they are coming from, their origins. And I was saying that Venus is a higher aspect of the earth. It's like an etheric body of the earth. So I thought it is very important to understand what is the lower aspect of the earth. And it's equally important as the higher aspect. And we need to know about this part of our cosmology in order to be able to integrate both polarities, the negative and the positive as well. So I will be talking about this and how this sphere, this lower vibrational sphere, which is called the eighth sphere, is affecting us, light workers, and humanity in general. So some of you might be already familiar with the concept of the eighth sphere. As I said, it is not a new concept. It has been around in our cosmology. It has been part of it for a long time. And those of you that are familiar with the teachings of Rudolf Steiner might have heard about the eighth sphere. And then also Edgar Cayce has been studying this. Also, many remote viewers have seen the eighth sphere, so it can be seen clairvoyantly. However, it is very important to talk about this and not to take it out of context, because taking it out of context, which has been happening in world religions, it is giving it a completely different meaning and a one-sided meaning. And understanding the real importance of the eighth sphere and the lower vibrational plane, it helps humanity to integrate the lower aspects of itself. So when we are understanding the importance of these lower vibrations, then we are understanding the importance of these vibrations within us as well. Because everything that is within us, it is being reflected in the cosmos as well. And the cosmos itself is being reflected in us. So when we are talking about our solar system, we are actually talking about a system that is working in perfect harmony and synergy. And the different planets are working in perfect synergy with each other and alchemy, and they are reflecting different aspects of us. And the sun being surrounded by these different planets and different aspects of the same energy, so these different aspects are being unified in the central sun. So every single planet in the solar system is basically a part of us. It is alive in us. And every single planet has a blueprint. And so the Earth does have a blueprint as well. And humanity has a blueprint as well. And what is happening with the Earth whenever it is going through an initiation and whenever it is going through an ascension? And we are going through the fourth initiation right now. So whenever this happens, there's always some residual energy, some leftover energy from thought forms, from trauma, from negative karma. That is being accumulated. And this is what the eighth sphere is representing, that residual energy that has been accumulated. So the eighth sphere deals with parasitic entities, with low vibrational entities. So we can say that it is a divergent sphere of human development. It is an artificial sphere. And it is made by this, as I said, leftover energy and residual energy that is not complete. that is unnatural and that is not aligning with Christ consciousness. So it is unnatural because everything that is not aligning with Christ consciousness, with the frequency of love, is unnatural. However, the eighth sphere is a natural manifestation of the process of expansion of humanity, so to speak. So it works like a mirror. It is mirroring humanity. It's almost like the upside down world. And humanity does have a cosmic connection to it, but is also within us. So imagine the Earth constantly interacting with different spheres, with different planes. And the Earth is constantly interacting with this sphere as well. So imagine whenever there is some leftover energy, some residual energy that is being accumulated and is being created by our unnatural thought forms, fragmentation of the soul as well, which is a trauma response. So due to trauma, our souls are being fragmented. And there's an intention behind the generational trauma that is being passed from generation upon generation. And it is being created by these lower vibrations, lower entities. So that residual energy that is being created by the fragmentation will feed over and over again the eighth sphere. So it is all interconnecting. So whenever these lower vibrational energies are being accumulated, they cannot move to higher levels because they don't have the energetic capacity to move to higher levels. So what happens is that they get accumulated on the lower astral and they are being absorbed by the eighth sphere. So we can say that the eighth sphere, it is being fed by these low vibrational energies, thought forms, negative karma of humanity, and the pain and the trauma as well. So it does have a parasitic relationship with the Earth. So humanity has a cosmic relationship with the eighth sphere, but it's also within us. It is reflecting the negative polarity that is within us. So it works like a mirror, like an upside down world. It is reflecting back to us everything that is not aligned with Christ consciousness. And the human collective consciousness does have a connection to the eighth sphere because of that. Now, clairvoyantly, it looks like a dark sphere that is encompassing the Earth and the Moon as well. Many clairvoyants have seen the eighth sphere, and remote viewers as well, and they describe it. Even Rudolf Steiner describes this eighth sphere as a dark sphere that is having a little bit of reddish color in it. So I think this is where the concept of hell is coming from, because of that reddish color and the heat as well, and the fire that is in hell, that horrible, very, very hot temperature that is coming from that eighth sphere. So it is a dark energy. It is an aspect of the Earth that could not pass this initiation. So it is a natural process of that initiation and the leftover energy. However, it is made of unnatural and synthetic energy, if that makes sense, because it's not aligned with the frequency of love. So it is made of this leftover energy of the Moon. So it is not only encompassing the Earth, but it's encompassing the Moon as well. And it's also made of the shadow aspect of Saturn and the incomplete energy of the Sun as well, which is being called the Black Sun. So it is representing the past of humanity. That's why the Moon is representing the past of humanity. And there is a shadow aspect of the Moon, which is part of the eighth sphere. And there's a shadow aspect of Saturn as well that is part of the eighth sphere. And there's a shadow aspect of the Sun as well, this incomplete energy of the Sun, which is also part of the eighth sphere. And the energy of these planets is reflecting the shadow aspects of humanity. And it is reflecting also the past phases of incarnations. And that's why Saturn is being said to be the planet of karma. And it's so interesting because once, a few months ago, I had a dream. And in my dream, I heard it clearly that if you want to know about your karma and your traumas as well, just look at Saturn, where it is being positioned in your chart. And I was like, wow, that just came out of nowhere. Like, Where did that come from, that information? So that was so interesting. So Saturn is reflecting that past of humanity and the moon as well. And it's very important to know that the moon itself and Saturn itself and the black sun are not bad or not negative, but there are some shadow aspects of them which are reflecting the shadow aspects of us. So there is a vibrational frequency of the moon and of Saturn and of the black sun that is present within us and other planets as well. But the only question is how much it is present, that vibrational frequency within us. And the more we are clearing up karma and working on our shadow aspects, and the more we are facing our shadows, the more we can transmute the eighth sphere and these aspects. So the eighth sphere works as a recycling chamber for that leftover energy, for the energy that is out of alignment, that is not in alignment with Christ consciousness. So this is where the idea and the concept of trapped souls is coming from. Because if more than 50% of your energy, of your soul, is negatively oriented, it is out of alignment and not aligned with Christ consciousness, then you will be sucked into this energy of the eighth sphere. And that's why many people in the spiritual communities as well, they describe this as a recycling process. And yes, indeed, there is a technology that was invented by these negative entities that is being used for that. So the eighth sphere works as a threshold that needs to be passed. And the soul entities have to vibrate on a certain vibrational frequency in order to pass that lower vibrational plane. So that technology that is being used for recycling the souls, so to speak, which we have heard about, and the false white light as well, that is being used to trap those souls, basically. And this is where the concept of trapped souls and Earth being a prison planet is coming from. So many people are describing this, and they are saying that we are being trapped here, there's no free will, and we are being recycled over and over again. And I want you to know that this is not accurate, because this is a very, very one-sided third dimensional perception. So beware of those spiritual teachers that are saying that you don't have free will, that you are being trapped here, that you are being recycled over and over again, and you cannot escape. Because this perception is the perception of those that are operating and that are getting information from the eighth sphere. And yes, there are many psychics and channelers that don't realize that they are actually getting information from the eighth sphere. So that's why spiritual bypassing and the new age spirituality that is being used as an escapism, and it's not integrated, it is ungrounded, is extremely dangerous. Because the perception of a person that hasn't integrated the heart and it's only operating from the mind will say that the earth is a prison planet. The earth is not a prison planet. It is a school. It is a school that is giving you the opportunity to graduate. So that's why I said that taking out of context things is also dangerous, because there is a recycling process that is going on over and over again, indeed, until the soul realizes that it has free will and it's starting to use its free will. So the eighth sphere is like a mirror, the mirror of the shadow self. And you need that mirror in order to look into it, something to reflect back that something is wrong there, something is out of alignment. So you can come out of that low vibration and start to integrate that shadow self. You start to work on your traumas and you start to realize that, oh, I don't need to be here. I can escape it. So that is not going on for an eternity. Eventually, Earth as well will disconnect from the eighth sphere. And I believe that we are in that process now. So you are being disconnected as well after a while. And we are being disconnected from the eighth sphere more and more as we are evolving. As we are evolving spiritually, as we are integrating the higher self, as we are integrating the heart, the energy of the heart. Because as I said, the heart works as a portal, as a metaphysical portal. So beware of those psychics that are saying that the Earth is a prison planet and there's no free will. Because psychic work that is being built on escapism without integration and without initiation can be trapped in this false light, in the eighth sphere. And you can tell when you are listening to the messages of those that are trapped here, because there is something off in those messages. There is a fear-based frequency there. And many of us have been or probably are asking, how do we know when we channel information if we are interacting with entities from the eighth sphere, from that lower astral, or we are interacting with entities from higher realms, from the fifth dimension? Well, we know that because the eighth sphere is synthetic. It is a parasitic sphere. It is a parasitic realm. The eighth sphere cannot evolve on its own internal mechanism. So the entity itself cannot really give you high vibrations. So imagine, it's very, very simple, actually. If any of you have had a toxic relationship ever, which we all had, like there's no light worker that has not gone through a toxic relationship. And that was serving for the initiation as well, for the integration and for the realization of the low vibrations. Many of us have had in our family dynamics, toxic relationships as well, since we were little children. So this is where the trauma is coming from. So imagine, let's say, an intimate relationship, because later on in life, in adulthood, intimate relationships are triggering the trauma. So let's say that you have just met a person and everything is so exciting between the two of you in the beginning. So there's this energy of excitement, of amazing physical relationship between the two of you as well. And there's a lot of emphasis on physicality, on the lower chakras. And they are presenting themselves as someone exciting, as someone loving, as someone who is caring as well. But as the relationship evolves, they start to show you their true colors. They will act weirdly in certain situations. They will say weird things. They will act manipulative as well, and they will act from the ego, and they will not support your sovereignty and your freedom. So this is exactly what is happening with these entities if you channel them. At some point, they will act as someone who is superior. Not like a teacher, but an entity that needs to be worshipped, that they are superior to you, that they know more than you do. So the more you are developing your heart and you're operating from the heart, the more you will have this sensor for BS. And that's why when you're listening to channelers, you can tell that something is off about the message that they are delivering. It is not coming from love. It is coming from the ego. So you can tell. According to Rudolf Steiner, those that are not using spirituality for integration and for awareness, but for escapism, they have this visionary clairvoyance that is very ungrounded. So lower entities only have the three lower chakras. They can only operate from those chakras. They can only work from there because the highest ones are not being developed. And these entities have a very, very weak emotional body or no emotional body at all. So you will hear these channelers talking about stories that are very material, physical oriented, like lower chakra oriented, but without the understanding of metaphysics and quantum reality. And this is what I noticed with these channelers and spiritual teachers, that their perspective is very, very one-sided and it's lacking empathy. And those channeled messages are lacking empathy. They might be intellectual, but they are lacking the approach of the heart. They are lacking the heart frequency. And when you are tuning into those messages with your heart, you can sense that. And that's why I always say that an individual has to vibrate above 200, which is the level of courage on that frequency scale, in order to receive messages and channeled messages and guidance that is not distorted. And in order to have the ability to discern falsehood from the truth. And many of these individuals and channelers would perceive, for example, the Freedom Convoy as well as a psyop, because they don't understand the heart. they don't have the capacity to connect to the frequency of the movement with their heart. They are only operating from the ego and from intellect. Okay, so according to Edgar Cayce, these souls that are being kind of trapped and sucked into the eighth sphere and into that very dense energy, over time their souls degrade. So their emotional body is starting to degrade. And when they reincarnate, they will incarnate with a very, very low energy, without the emotional body, without the etheric body. So there is a complete disconnection from the higher self, from the heart, is going on here. And that's why there's no capacity for the soul to start again where they have left off in the previous incarnation. So a soul that has graduated and has gone through many initiations, through lifetimes, they will incarnate to a human body that is reflecting their present vibrational frequency. So they might have to start again to a certain degree because they are spiritual amnesia, so they will not remember where they are coming from, and they will have to go through again a few tests and to integrate the polarity. However, they will not start again from zero. So most of the beings of light or light workers and star seeds that are working for the light and they are operating from the heart, they normally start their incarnation with a frequency level above 200, that is above courage. And then that might go down, but then they will bounce back. And this is what happened with me as well. So we have been all tricked at some point in this incarnation. And even the spiritual bypassing, it was like that trickster energy, you know, when we have been using spirituality, many of us, not all of us, but many of us have used spirituality in the past for escapism. So that was a trickster energy, a distorted view as well. And many of us had incarnations as well where we have been recycled or we have been trapped in a loop. And actually, once I was told that I was tricked in the past by the Orions, by the Orion Collective as well. But then I came out of that energy, of that trickster energy. So this happens, you know, with many of the star seeds, because it's part of the integration. But we will eventually disconnect from that trickster energy. But what happens with those souls that are denying their true nature and they are completely disconnected from their higher self, they are being cut off completely. When they are being recycled, they need to start it over again, but from zero, like over again, because they have such a weak emotional body that they don't have the capacity to carry on. There's not enough energy that is available to carry on. So it needs to start over. And that is the energy of Saturn as well. And that's why they are using it in these secret societies. Saturn is a symbol of starting over, the unzipping of the soul. So these parasitic entities of the eighth sphere that are being trapped there, many of them are incarnated currently on the Earth. And those are those beings that unconsciously are terrified of the eighth sphere and of the entrapment in the eighth sphere. So they need to come up with technology that is providing them with eternal life, because they are not aware with it, but they are terrified actually of that entrapment, of that reincarnation with low vibrational energy over and over again. So they do everything subconsciously to avoid that, to avoid starting again. And that's why they want eternal life. That's why they want to avoid reincarnation. That's why they need to play God, because they are cut off from God. And that's why they see artificial intelligence as well as their God. And they are worshiping these entities. They are worshiping the entities of the A sphere. And they are connecting with these interdimensionals as well that are being trapped in the eighth sphere. So the eighth sphere is not something that was created by these low vibrational entities. The eighth sphere is merely an energy that is reflecting them, that is trapping them, that is being fed over and over again by this residual energy. So these humans that are being incarnated right now, and they are low vibrational, they are in contact with these entities from the eighth sphere, and they are receiving guidance from them. They are looking at them as their masters. And this is where transhumanism comes in picture. They want to bind themselves to humanity and to transform humanity into something synthetic as well, that will bring eternal life to them. So the biology of humans needs to be synthetic, needs to be changed. And this is what the jabs are for, to change the biology, the genetic imprint of humanity, and to cut them off, to cut the souls off from their higher self. So the eighth sphere is not something to be afraid of. It is not something to avoid, because it is within us, but it's something to understand. We have to understand the eighth sphere and the metaphysics of the eighth sphere, and not to be afraid of it, but to face it, because it is within us. And I want all of you to know that the way to go beyond the eighth sphere, which you have done already, we have all done, whoever is watching this video right now has done that. So the way to go beyond the eighth sphere is to develop the heart, is to work from the heart, being aligned with the Christ consciousness, with the Christ stream. I don't want anyone to be afraid of that. And that's why I wanted to clear the misconception around it. Don't worry about your soul being recycled, because it cannot be when you are operating from the heart. It cannot be. And those that are being afraid of being tricked or being trapped or interacting with low vibrational entities, those that are channeling and are afraid of that energy, it means that they still need to integrate that aspect of themselves. And when you integrate that, there's no fear around it. You just connect to the heart and you feel that Christ consciousness in your heart. So there's no negative entity that will come through. And even if they come through, you will spot the BS, like immediately. You will recognize it. So they will let go of you, because there's nothing that they can feed themselves with. They cannot feed themselves off you and your vibration. You're not a vibrational match to them, in other words. And those that haven't passed the initiation and have not integrated the lower chakras to start integrating and to operate from the heart, those are afraid of the death of the physical body, and those are afraid of the concept of hell, of this lower astral plane. So the eighth sphere is not something to be afraid of, but it's something that we need to understand, and we need to understand the importance of it, the importance of that mirroring effect. And not to forget that the eighth sphere cannot evolve via its own internal mechanism. It needs something external. It needs external energy. That's why it's parasitic. And those souls that are being trapped in the eighth sphere, they will be trapped there only temporarily. And temporarily can mean millions of years, because time is non-linear, but eventually they will wake up to their own potential and their free will, and they will disconnect. And the earth will disconnect at some point from the eighth sphere. So I hope this clarified a little bit the concept of the lower astral levels, and it has cleared some misconceptions as well. I was repeating a lot myself in this video, but that is needed for the understanding of these abstract concepts. And it's needed this concept to be approached from different directions. So thank you again for everyone who is supporting my YouTube and who is supporting my Patreon. Take care of yourselves, and I cannot wait to see you next time. Kisses to you all.